I am going to leave you with the word that. With the word? With the word, everybody? That. Okay, what is it? Come on, say it with me. What is it? That. Remember this in all your life. T-H-A-T. That. Number one is T, isn't it? The first T. Taqwa. What is it?
Taqwa.
Remember this. Taqwa is the most heaviest deed on the day of judgment. That's why you will see when you flip through the verses of the Quran, each and every page nearly you will see that Allah is reminding us of taqwa. هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ Allah talks about the people of taqwa here. That, who are the successful ones? The ones with the taqwa. If you look at the verse of Hajj as well. وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ عِدُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنِ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا فَلَا رَفَثَ وَلَا فُسُوقَ وَلَا جِدَالَ فِي الْحَجِّ وَمَا تَفْعَلُ مِنْ خَيْرٍ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهِ وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى When you go Hajj, Allah reminded us about taqwa. If you look at the verse of Psalm as well, fasting, what did it say? كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامِ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Again he says that taqwa is the most important thing in siyam, in Hajj, in zakah, in a person's life, taqwa is very, very important. Taqwa is the most important thing. There are several ahadith regarding taqwa, but taqwa, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, أَثْقَبُ مَا يُضَعُ فِي الْمِزَانِ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ The heaviest deed on the scale of Day of Judgment is taqwa. What's the heaviest deed?
Taqwa.
That's number one. Next one is A. No, what is it?
H.
So what do we have for H? It could be halal, but taqwa is halal.
Hadith.
When you have taqwa, then that's halal. Halal means that you've got taqwa. Abstaining from all the haram means that you have got taqwa. Haya. Haya, shalom. Okay? What is it?
Haya.
Haya. Haya, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, there are more than 70 branches of iman. How many more? More than 70 branches of iman. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, one of them is haya. Subhanallah. He could have mentioned all the others, but he didn't mention any of them. Because this one is very important. Sharam haya di dinata hai, manushar mukde te, biya shadi ho hai, yi daman ko dira biya hai. O degree of na dhasa da ho duna. Degree of na degree of duna, kitab da hai. Maat si na na. Baya dhu gullah hat. But haya di dita khayin, really, some people they make it up. Daman do you want like a zeh shara ono? Kubi maldi hari. But zeh mehu biya hoi jana ni bishar ta wadhe hoko la handi uli mangi jai. So we don't want to be that. May Allah take care of us. Say ameen. So number one is taqwa. Number two is haya. Okay, number H, haya. And then number three, which is the most important, the heaviest of all, which is akhlaq. What is it? The good manners. Good manners. Good manners. So everyone, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in the same hadith, أَثْقَلُ مَا يُوضَعُ فِي الْمِيزَانِ تَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ The best of manner is the best to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ أَحَبَّكُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said that the best and the most beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what? The one who has good akhlaq. There's two, good akhlaq and bad akhlaq, but the good akhlaq. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said, إِنَّ أَقْرَبَكُمْ إِلَيَّ فِي يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَاسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا امرا شو سايني الله رسول الله لوگه قیامت اور دین زوریا تختا ان شاء الله تو فائدہ نہیں سو رسول اللہ صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم has said the closest to me on the day of judgment is the one with the best akhlaq Allahu akbar how beautiful is it to have a child with good akhlaq how beautiful is it to have the shopkeeper with good akhlaq how beautiful is it to have the customer with good akhlaq. How beautiful is it that the marketplace, all the people there are full of good akhlaq as well. You want to go there because the market is the market of akhlaq. The place is place of akhlaq. How beautiful is it that when a woman also observes this akhlaq as well, when a child observes this akhlaq, when the prime minister observes this akhlaq as well, that everyone is observing this quality known as good akhlaq, good manners, which is the greatest thing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The closest a person will be is according to the best akhlaq, according to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. The hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Finally, that, isn't it? T-H-A-R-A-T, which is very important. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he used to regularly do this. And that is tawbah. What is that?
Tawbah.
Allahu Akbar. This is very important. Every prophet, if you see the verses regarding every prophet, you will see that after, at the end of their story, they are always confirming about them doing tawbah at the end. Allahu Akbar. رب اغفر لي ولوالدي ولمن دخل بيتي مؤمنا وللمؤمنين والمؤمنات ولا تزد الظالمين. حضرت نوح عليه الصلاة والسلام, حضرت إبراهيم عليه السلام, حضرت يوسف عليه الصلاة والسلام, at the end حضرت يعقوب عليه السلام, حضرت يوسف عليه السلام, all together they all ask for forgiveness from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Tawbah is the most important thing in our life. When we wake up in the morning, we are supposed to do tawbah for anything that we have done during the night time. When we, before we go to sleep, we are supposed to what? Do tawbah. Because we have definitely done things that have made Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry. Or we have done something that is against deen. Our eyes have not done things that are good. Our ears may have not done things that are good. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had said that I myself, being the best of prophets, best of messengers, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me every single day 100 times. 100 times the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, oh Allah, maaf koriya dukha. Ami je dawatur kham korte waslam, eta shodik bhabe korchi na, oh Allah, apni amare maaf koriya dukha. And imagine us, we're not doing the work of da'wah, but still we are doing so many things that are against Allah. So it is necessary for us that we take care of that. We take care of what? Okay, let's recap quickly. Number one, T, what is it?
Taqwa.
Taqwa. You understand taqwa? Yes. Huh? Allah conscious, which means if I do anything wrong, if I do haram, I do any, look, I amar taqwa ba saibu amare. Allah, Allah, taqwa. Ami haram khaita. Or if I'm going to watch a movie, Allah, taqwa. Ye shumai tu di mali kul mota yo te. Movie dekhiya mali kul mota. Hey, dekho wala dekhe. Thaas tuus. So the first thing is T for taqwa. And then hate for? Haya, shorom. Bangladi taqwa hai? Shorom. Allah amra re, shorom paaye taqwa. Ameen. And then A for? Akhlaq. The best one is with the good manners. Chief Sawal was Dawdu Dine ni tarzi akhlaq ta khair. Kholya sayo. Hey, trus wata ni kore na. Ambo kholya shayta ni kore. Hey, ego dekhi akhlaq ta khair. Hesin ta khurmo, kholya tare bala khair. Because everyone loves good manners. Everyone loves good manners. And the final one is what, everybody?
Tawbah.
Final one is tawbah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the good news. He says, Inna Allah yuhibbu tawabin wa yuhibbu al-mutatahirin. Allah loves the people who do tawbah, and Allah loves the people who remain clean and tidy. So gore shor somoy tidy rakhbai. Ye school e shomoy kholi e shomoy khuliao bish ghorite mari. No, don't do that. Tidy rakhbai ar sob somoy bathroom clean rakhmu. আর টয়লেট ক্লিন রাখবো, আর কিচেন ক্লিন রাখবো, আর কাপড় চোপড় ক্লিন রাখবো, যদি দেখি নাই খাস্তাতে আমার ডিউটি হইলো, আমার ঘরের মধ্যে হেল্প করতাম, আই শুড হেল্প আউট, সো দ্যাট ইটস অল ক্লিন, বিকজ আল্লাহ লাভস দ্য পিপল, দ্য হাউস দ্যাট ফলোস দিস টু থিংস ইজ দ্য বেস্ট হাউস, দ্য ওয়ান উইচ রেগুলারলি ডাজ তাওবা এন্ড দ্য ওয়ান অলওয়েজ রিমেইনস ক্লিন এন্ড টাইডি. হোয়াট? ক্লিন এন্ড টাইডি. মে আল্লাহ সুবহানাহু ওয়া তাআলা গিভ এভরিওয়ান তাওফিক. নাও ফাইনালি উই কাম টু দ্য ফাইনাল স্টেজ হিয়ার. I'm sure everyone knows that this is a mosque which has a loan of 15,000 pounds from Radha Pound Mulhoi, Rini Mosque, Allah Pak Parwardigare.